Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, good evening and welcome to today's corporate praise and worship. We are happy to see all of you and for this opportunity to gather as a family to love, honor, praise, and worship our Creator and Almighty Father. Let us pray in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We honor God's covenant of love through praying and preaching of His Word. This is our community theme for the fifth Sunday of the Ordinary Time. It brings our focus on our Lord Jesus Christ, who prayed to be always in communion with God the Father, so that His actions flow from His life of prayer. Brothers and sisters, when we truly believe and follow Christ, there is no fear, because love casts out all fear. We can be still in the midst of pain and sufferings of this world, because God's word in Psalm 147 assures us of His promise. Great is our Lord and mighty in power. To His wisdom there is no limit. Let us welcome the Lord and one another, Christ in each one of us. So let us give our smiles and greetings from our hearts to our brothers and sisters who are with us now. We pray twice when we sing. So let us lift our grateful hearts to God by singing together. For He is good and His love endures forever. Day by day, every moment, it is good to give thanks to our God. Lord, we bless Your holy name.
We humbly come before You. We are unworthy to even utter Your most holy name. We implore Your grace and beg You, please send us Your Holy Spirit to help us in this moment of prayer. We desire to pray to You sincerely and truthfully from our hearts. Holy Spirit of the living God, we need You. Be with us now. Holy Spirit, You are the spring of living water, filling us with eternal life. Cleanse us and fill us with Your love. O Holy Spirit, most holy Paraclete, come, move in us and change us to pray as we should. Work through us to proclaim with our lives that Jesus Christ is our Savior and our King. you are among us. Brothers and sisters, we know more about our Lord God through His Word. We seek guidance from Him, and he teaches us to follow him. Let us now listen intently to the word of God.
Our reading from the book of Job. Job spoke, saying, "Is not man's life on earth a drudgery? Are not his days those of hirelings? He is a slave who longs for the shade, a hireling who waits for his wages. So I have been assigned months of misery, and troubled nights have been allotted to me. If in bed I say, 'When shall I arise?' then the night drags on. I am filled with restlessness until dawn. My days are swifter than a weaver's shuttle. They come to an end without hope. Remember that my life is like wind. I shall not see happiness again." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, if I preach the gospel, this is no reason for me to boast, for an obligation has been imposed on me. And woe to me if I do not preach it. If I do so willingly, I have a recompense. But if unwillingly, then I have been entrusted with a stewardship. What then is my recompense? That when I preach, I offer the gospel free of charge, so as to make full use of my right in the gospel. Although I am free in regard to all, I have made myself a slave to all, so as to win over as many as possible. To the weak, I became weak to win over the weak. I have become all things to all to save at least some. And this I do for the sake of the gospel, so that I too may have a share in it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please all rise to acclaim the gospel.
From the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
On leaving the synagogue, Jesus entered the house of Simon and Andrew with James and John. Simon's mother-in-law lay sick with a fever. They immediately told him about her. He approached, grasped her hand, and helped her up. Then the fever left her, and she waited on them. When it was evening after sunset, they brought to him all who were ill or possessed by demons. The whole town was gathered at the door. He cured many who were sick with various diseases, and he drove out many demons, not permitting them to speak because they knew him. Rising very early before dawn, he left and went off to a deserted place where he prayed. Simon and those who were with him pursued him, and on finding him said, "Everyone is looking for you," he told them. "Let us go to the nearby villages that I may preach here also. For this purpose have I come." So he went into their synagogues, preaching and driving out demons throughout the whole of Galilee. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
In the Gospel according to St. Mark, in chapter 1, we heard, "Rising very early before dawn, Jesus left and went off to a deserted place where he prayed." Pope Benedict XVI said, "The church does three essential things. The church worships God, the church serves the poor, and the church evangelizes. The church is the mystical body of Christ, and Jesus prayed, so the church prays. And we, as baptized members of the church, we pray as we should. Our relationships with other people are important, but first is the foundation of all our relationships. It is our relationship with the Lord. All other relationships are grounded in our relationship to the Lord." In the homily of Bishop Robert Barron, he said, "Unless we go off to our deserted place to pray like Jesus, everything else in our Christian life is reduced to something it should not be. What is your desert place? That place where you spend time just being in touch and trying to maintain your relationship with God. It might be your morning prayers and meditation on the scripture readings. Maybe for some, a time you spend at the Mass or in adoration of the Blessed Sacrament. In our community, we meet a lot and talk about practical concerns and decisions that have to be made. Therefore, we need to be rooted in prayer for us to be successful in the spiritual order." Saint Mark further tells us, "On leaving the synagogue, Jesus entered the house of Simon and Andrew with James and John. Simon's mother-in-law lay sick with a fever. They immediately told him about her. He approached, grasped her hand, and helped her up. Then the fever left her, and she waited on them. When it was evening, they brought to him all who were ill or possessed by demons. He cured many who were sick with various diseases, and he drove out many demons. Here is the second great task of the church. First, the church prays. Secondly, the church serves the poor." The poor, in every expression of poverty. Yes, the economically poor. But it also means the emotionally poor, the spiritually poor. It means the intellectually poor. It means those who are poor because they have not heard the word of God. The second basic task of the church, born of prayer, is service. Why? Because the more you are in touch with God, the more that divine love will start flowing through you into the world. Through our love and service, we reach out to a hurting world. We do not need to go far. Our families, neighbors, co-workers, employers, brothers and sisters in community, and that one person we know is suffering. We invite people to our community. We pray for those who ask for our prayers. We sacrifice our time to make ourselves available to others even when we are busy and tired. We console those who mourn, and we help bury the dead in our community wake masses. We share our time, talent, and resources to support the life of our community. We visit the sick and people who are in prison. These are some ways we can share in the church's task of serving the poor. And the third task of the church, The church prays. The church serves the poor. And finally, the church evangelizes. In the gospel, Jesus told them, "Let us go on to the nearby villages, that I may preach there also. For this purpose have I come." So he went into their synagogues, preaching and driving out demons throughout the whole of Galilee. Jesus serves and heals, and he has come to preach the word of God, to evangelize. Repent, the kingdom is at hand. Believe the good news, he proclaims. And in the second reading from St. Paul, in his first letter to the Corinthians, he says, "If I preach the gospel, this is no reason for me to boast, for an obligation has been imposed on me, and woe to me if I do not preach it. This is a real Christian being on fire with a desire to evangelize. How about us? Some of us may feel, I'm not yet ready. Maybe if I am in the right circumstance or I do not have the time. We pray, yes. We serve the poor, yes. And we evangelize. We speak the word of God. We strive to learn God's word to be able to preach it. Our community teachings, for example, is an opportunity to know more about God and His Word. Brothers and sisters, there is so much poverty, sickness, and suffering in this world. We, who are members of the mystical body of Christ, are supposed to be other Christs. Let us ask for the grace to love like Jesus in our prayers, service, and preaching of God's word, so that we may bring to Him people who are suffering, people who are sick and need to be healed, and people who hunger for God. To love them like Jesus is our desire. Amen."
Trying
looking to you. Just love them like Jesus, carry them to Him. His yoke is easy, His burden is light. You don't need the answers to all of life's questions. Just know that He loves them. Stay by their side. Love them like Jesus. Of all creation holds our life in His hand. The God of all the nations hold our lives in His hand. The rock of all salvation hold our lives in His hands. He cares for them just as He cares for you. Just love them like Jesus.
Powerful Triune God, we humbly plead for your mercy and compassion. Forgive us when we fail to love as you love. Help us when we fail to pray as we should and for neglecting our relationship with you. We repent of all the times we allow our desire for comfort and pleasure to erode our holy desire to take up our cross and follow you. We cower in the face of trials and worry instead of bringing all our concerns to you in prayer. Lord God, maker of heaven and earth, our time belongs to you. Yes, we give our time to serve you in our community. But you, Lord, look into our hearts. Will you find love in our hearts, an undivided love of you, and the fervent desire to know you and obey your commands? Will you find compassion for people in need beating in our hearts and the courage to alleviate their situation? Will you find a grateful heart, aware of the countless blessings and graces you bestow on us every day? How could we forget you, Lord, and what you have done to save us? Forgive us our ingratitude. Lord, we need you. Forgive and heal our repentant hearts so that we can worthily serve you and truthfully proclaim your word with our lives. My right.
righteousness, O God, how I need you. Where sin run deep, your grace is more. Where grace is found is where you are. And where you
Brothers and sisters, the Lord has given everything we need and granted our prayers with his love and care for our own souls. With thanksgiving for all blessings received, please bring your love offerings and tithes and the petitions of our community and place them in the basket. We pray for the grace to have a heart like Jesus, giving our lives as a willing sacrifice in his work of saving souls. brothers and sisters, let us ask God, our Father, to strengthen us in our trials and afflictions and provide for our needs. We humbly kneel as we lift to Him our petitions. With loving trust in His goodness, we respond confidently with words of affirmation to every petition. For the church and church leaders, we pray for Pope Francis, Haro Archbishop Jose Lazo, all bishops and members of the Catholic clergy and the religious, that they may continue to give hope and courage to our troubled world by preaching and teaching the life-giving word of God. We pray.
Yes, Father. Amen.
For civil authorities and world leaders, that they may act with genuine concern for the plight of those in their care and strive to build a just and peaceful society, protecting the lives and welfare of people, especially the poor, we pray.
Yes, Lord. Amen.
For persons who are suffering from abuse, injustice, poverty, disease, hunger, calamities, emotional and psychological afflictions, that they receive help, proper care, healing and restoration through the prayers and charitable acts from people and institutions, we pray.
Hear our story.
For our BLD community, our global spiritual director, Bishop Reynaldo Evangelista, district spiritual director, Father Kenneth Espeleta, all BLD priests, leaders and members, that we proclaim the love of Christ through service and actively participate in the life of our community, we pray.
Yes, Lord.
For the fulfillment of plans and success of our community activities, especially the forthcoming Basic Bible Seminar and Marriage Encounter in Calibo DIP, we especially pray for the protection and guidance of the BBS and ME Calibo DIP participants, that they will be free from all hindrances and heed God's invitation to a loving relationship with Him through our community, we pray.
Yes, Lord, grace and mercy.
For people who need healing from illness and health problems, especially Bob Saria, Francis Peñafiel, Dr. Grace Fernandez, Emarie Manal, Ira Gianna Lim, Ramon Alba III, Josie Dimaisip, Johnny Matias, Arturo Magbanwa, Aida Iguico, Wilhelm Yoro, Isai Hortilio, Lalaine Griengo, Bimbim Doromal, Mark Luigi Aposaga, TJ Doromal, William Jackson Perez, Perla Alba, Zachary Jan Artaho, Amy D., Emma Kagod, Aiden Azriel Fuentes, and Tetet Hipolito, that they receive relief, healing, and restoration through the prayers and comforting presence of family, friends, community, and people taking care of them, we pray.
Yes, Lord, by your grace and mercy. For
the repose of the souls of our family and community members who have returned to our heavenly home ahead of us, especially Ramon Alba Jr., Antonio Sr. and Elsa Artaho, Ramon Sr. and Lourdes Alba, Julio and Nieves Balaran, Nenita and Gary Lara, Archbishop Angel Dameo, Father Doming Alimahen, Martin Delgado, Zyril Arroyo, Pinky Opinion, Arlene Samson, May and Frank Lacson, Sim Lina and Joey Grino, Joe Del Gulfo, Jose Muico Jr., Sean Paul Jacolina, Cesar Montelibano Jr., Florencia Mercado, Francisco Maravilla, Consuelo Lidesma, Catherine Salem, Dino Haina, Captain Benito Ammo Monpon, Theody Cabizan, Evan Chris Alvarez, and Lucy Fradejas, and all the souls in purgatory. Grant them, Lord, the glory of resurrection, and give us a share in their happiness, we pray.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
We lay our hands over our love offerings and written petitions. Loving Father, we humbly present these gifts out of gratitude and thanksgiving for your abundant blessings. Sanctify these offerings to support the work you entrusted our BLD community. We also lift up to you the written prayer intentions with complete trust that you will answer them out of your goodness and most holy will. We pray.
Yes, Lord, Jesus, we pray.
In silence, we pray for our personal intentions and the urgent concerns of our community. We pray.
Yes, Sir Jesus, we pray.
Let us pray our community prayer. Lord Jesus, you said that all will know we are truly your disciples by the love we bear for one another. You pray that your disciples may all be one, just as you and the Father are one. We pray, Jesus, for the same unity of heart and mind, that in you we too may be one with the Father. Lord, we have a covenant with you to follow your commandments, especially that of loving one another and living in unity. Beyond our circumstances and concerns, our fears and craving for recognition, grant us the grace to overcome our tendency to be oversensitive and judgmental of one another. May we always remember that in matters of community concerns, our leaders speak for you and have the good of the community at heart. Let your Holy Spirit flow freely into our hearts and minds, that we too may share in the mutual love between you and the Father. May harmony reign in our community life and activities. Banish all bitterness, petty bickering, and strife from our midst. Help us to be holy as you are holy, to love one another as you have loved us. Remind us always to lift up our hearts in prayer. Nourish us by your word and strengthen us through your sacraments. Make us one, Lord Jesus, for it is good when we dwell as one. And there you will lavish blessings upon us. In your name, Jesus, we pray. Amen.
As the deer longs for streams of water, so my soul longs for you, O God. For your love is better than life. My lips will speak your praise. Lord Jesus, how we long to see your face. In the mystery of your divine presence, we perceive your light piercing our hearts. In the beauty of your creation, we see a glimpse of your greatness and your love beyond our understanding. Who is God but you? Who removes guilt, pardons sin, and delights in mercy? Your love is everlasting, and you continue to love us, even in our failings. You alone can hear our cries. You alone can heal our broken hearts. O Lord our God, you are most holy. You are most compassionate. You alone are God eternal. Lord, we love you. There is none like you.
Search for all eternity long, and
Almighty and eternal Father, we come before your most holy throne. You are our God and Redeemer. We are your people, the flock you shepherd. We give you praise and thanksgiving. Lord Jesus Christ, arise, our Lord and King, creator of unfailing light. You are brighter than all the stars in heaven. We are in awe of your glory. We bow down and worship you. In your most holy name, we lift up our hands. All power and might belongs to you. You are the living Word of God. How inscrutable your wisdom. We adore you, sweet and gentle Jesus. We celebrate you forever. There are shouts of joy and victory in the tents of the just. For you alone deserve honor, glory, majesty, and the highest praise. We praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Brighter than Joy of the Lord.
We love you, Lord. Most loving Father, we thank you for your countless blessings. Thank you for this special moment for us to be with you in prayer. Thank you for restoring our minds and bodies. We deeply thank you for the gift of family, friends, community, and every person we encounter. Thank you for answering our prayers, always for the good of our own souls. We sincerely thank you for the answered prayers of our community, for care and help for those in need, for safe travel, for physical healing, for family reunions bringing joy and good memories, for guidance and intervention in a critical situation, for the generous sharing of time, talent, and treasure in our community life, for all these generous blessings and so much more. Thank you, dear Lord. Brothers and sisters, we will now listen to our community announcements.
Good evening, brothers and sisters in Christ. We give thanks to our Lord Jesus Christ for tonight's corporate praise and worship. Thank you to all of you who are present here now at St. Clement's Church this evening. We would like to invite the other members to please join us by attending physically here every Thursday to our community masses or praise and worship, beginning with the praying of the community rosary at exactly 6:15 p.m. We have resumed with our face-to-face word-sharing circle last January 17, 2024, held at the BLD Hall. Thank you to all who took time and joined us in our important activity. For now, we will continue holding our face-to-face WSC once a month every Wednesday until such time that we will resume holding it weekly. For the rest of the weeks, please continue holding it online with your regular WSC circles and schedules. Our next face-to-face schedule will be on February 21, 2024 at the BLD Hall. We will hold the basic Bible study on February 17 and 18 at the St. Clement's Retreat House. All qualified members who have not yet taken the BBS are invited to attend this important teaching. A minimal fee of 800 pesos will help in the expenses of this two-day seminar. We are asking for your prayers and support for the success of this community activity. More details will be given soon. All concerned members, please take note of the following schedule of class reunions to be held at the BLD Hall. ME number 41 on February 9, 1:30 to 4 p.m. SPE number 19, February 10, 8 to 12 noon. YE 16 at February 10, 3 to 6 p.m. FE number 15, February 11, 1 to 4 p.m. Mark 10, February 17 at 1 to 3 p.m. And SE number 18, February 10, 9 to 12 noon, the venue will be Pototan Parish Church Convent. The BLD Calibo District in process will be holding their ME weekend number 8 on February 24 to 25 at Aklan State University campus. To all members who have relatives or friends in Calibo, please invite couples there to join the ME weekend. You can get a copy of the couple information sheet from Calibo DIP DLs Ariel and Ping Aquino, or from our mission stewards, Tita Elton and Tita Cora Malacaman. Please pray for the success of said encounter. The digital format of our BLD publication, Encounters, has additional articles uploaded by the Word Ministry. These articles can be viewed on its website. The links are posted on our FB page and shared in our chat groups. For love offerings and tithings, please note our community bank details or send via money transfer to our management DCS, Jerry Arenas. Thank you very much. See you again next week. Have a safe travel home. Good night.
Most compassionate and loving Father, as we come to the closing of this corporate praise and worship, we thank you for the gift of your holy presence and for calling us to pray. Keep us in your care and help us bring Jesus to our families, friends, neighbors, and every person who hunger for you. Brothers and sisters, the love we receive is meant to be shared especially to those who need love the most. Let your prayers, thoughts, words, and actions bring the presence, joy, and peace of Christ. Let us tell the world of God's love.
Save those who
be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Good evening. God bless us all.
Thank you.